to everybody once more time. We do have some newcomers here. My name is Christina, and I will present my project called The Thief's Puzzle. You know, I really like the title of my project because when I, for example, do have my vacation suddenly, and I go to my countryside, I enjoy collecting puzzles, and I do have a lot of them in my countryside. And I have thought that collecting a puzzle has one thing in common with the interpersonal communication. I mean that one puzzle put incorrectly and the whole image is broken, right? So the same thing we do have when we have some conversation, like interpersonal communication. One puzzle, one word said incorrectly, and you will never establish a very confident like connection with your partner, right? So today I would like to talk with you about the fifth puzzle of the interpersonal communication, about establishing contact. For those who know me quite well, and for those who don't me, I will comment that I have already presented four projects from the same manual called interpersonal communication. And I would say that every topic refers to some special skill of interpersonal communication. And let's remember them briefly. So the first puzzle is called conversing with ease. It means that you know how to open the conversation, how to approach a person, how to start the conversation, and which mechanism are used for doing that in a very confident way. The second puzzle of our big puzzle of interpersonal communication is called negotiate successfully. It means that you know how to negotiate in order to maybe declare your own point of view, right? To support your material. The third puzzle of our big puzzle is called diffusing verbal criticism. And from my point of view, it's one of the most difficult tasks to do. To diffuse some criticism, both I would say verbal and non-verbal. The fourth one is called coach. Have you ever heard this word?
Yeah.
Coach, right. So while you're talking with somebody, you can also help him. For example, taking some resolution or declaring some opinion. So it's about coaching. And the fifth puzzle of our big puzzle of interpersonal communication is called asserting yourself effectively. That's why the title of my project is the title of my project is The Fifth Puzzle, the fifth skill of an interpersonal communication. And today my task is to talk with you about how to assert yourself successfully. But before that, to break the ice, I would like to ask you if you don't understand correctly the meaning of the word, of the verb to assert yourself. What does it mean in your opinion?
To be confident.
To be confident, right. Some other versions. Okay, to be persuasive, yeah, I do agree with you. So let's make a question to the Oxford Dictionary. So the Oxford English Dictionary says that it means to declare something with assurance, behaving in a confident and determined way in order to declare your own opinion. I would say that to declare confident and opinion are key words here. So it means that you can assert yourself effectively, declaring your opinion in a confident way. That's why the most challenging skills, because here you do have to use both verbal and non-verbal techniques, both mental and physical actions. But instead of, for example, blaming somebody or maybe fixing a problem, why just not to try to resolve it? Why just not try to talk? And today I would like to give you a four-step outline how to assert yourself. yourself effectively. And before that, I would like to ask the audience to help me a bit. I think that everybody knows how to read using the English language, right? Okay, so please, a bit of smile and let's read together. The first step of my outline. Diana, please read it loudly as a Toastmaster.
State the problem. Describe what is bothering you.
Perfect. So state the problem. The second point is lady in red.
Tell about your feelings. Explain how the problem can affect you.
Perfect. Thank you. The third step, maybe you, I don't know, what's your name?
Mary.
Nice to meet you. So the third step.
Specify a solution, assert or ask in a firm and non-hostile tone of voice.
Perfect. And the last I will read because maybe you don't see it so well. Describe the positive consequences. Mention advantages for both of you. So it's a very theoretical structure of a good asserting yourself. But still we can use it for being effective. And there are some like very, very simple tips for doing that. And I would like to mention, because not only the information itself is important, right? But also the way we present this piece of information. So the third thing is that you should be very open-minded and open to the public and to your partner. The second thing that you should speak immediately. So don't accumulate those negative emotions that you may have had. The third one is that you should always smile and you should be pleasant with your partner in order to resolve effectively the problem. So maybe some of you might say that there are so stupid words that you are talking about, but actually we forget about them in the moment when we state the problem. I would say that a conversation, it's like a big, big puzzle. And every detail of this big puzzle has its own information. I mean a piece of image, right? Like in an interpersonal communication, or like during a conversation. A conversation, it's a life organism which depends on both of the partners. And not every time it goes as it was planned by yourself. But still, you're able to resolve this problem, you're able to continue presenting your information in order to make the other person follow your instructions and fulfill your request, but in a very non-hostile tone of voice. And after this big puzzle of interpersonal communication, I do hope so, with our audience, we will have a little role play. So the second part of my project is to show you how could it work. Of course, yes, it's in a scenario. Yeah, we do have some circumstances, but it wasn't planned how it will go then. Before the meeting, I asked the member of Toastmaster community, our friend Gaia Ganisyan, to help me. So with Gaia, we talked only about the consequences. And I think that they will be very familiar for everybody. So, she is a newcomer in a Toastmaster club. And she enters while a person is on the stage presenting his or her speech. And what will happen, we'll see now. And my objective is to try to resolve the problem according to that our four-step outline and trying to use all the tips I have mentioned. So the second part of our topic of my project is started and I welcome Gaia. Okay, so here we can talk. My name is Christina. I'm a member of the Toastmaster Club. You are for the first time, right?
Yes.
Okay, and Maybe some words. How did you learn about the Toastmaster Club?
I was just passing and someone was speaking. That's all.
You enjoy speaking?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
Like all of us.
And would you like to practice it by yourself?
Maybe.
Okay.
But I'm too shy.
You are too shy.
Like you didn't see it, but yes, I'm shy.
Okay. So now we have a meeting. So during every meeting, we do have different speeches and speakers. And if you want, you now could enter the room. But you know that we do have some like rules for the meeting. Yeah, so you know the first rule is just to turn off the sound of your mobile phone, okay? Because as you see there, we do have a speaker who is for the very first time on the stage. And usually they, you know, they are very nervous and we try not to interrupt them at all, okay? So it's like respect for them.
Yeah, I see, I won't do it again.
Okay, and your mobile phone also, I hope.
Yes.
So now it's in the silent mode. Okay, perfect. And also then I will pass you a special paper where you could write maybe some details of your mobile phone, your email, if you want to receive some feedback from us, some information.
I want also to be like this speaker. He's so good on the stage.
Yeah, but you know that this speaker is only with his first speech. Can you imagine? But you can be as good as him.
And how soon it will be?
You know, we do have a special system, education system in Toastmasters, right? But as for now, I must be inside of the room, so I just can't help you right now.
I see. Okay, so maybe we'll talk later and you'll tell me more information about Toastmasters.
You know, we'll have a pause just like in 10 minutes, like after the second speaker.
Okay.
So maybe during the break, you can approach me and I will give you all the papers about the Toastmasters and we'll tell you briefly how does it work.
Yeah, maybe then I can enjoy my banana.
But still, if you want, you can enjoy your banana right here, right now. I will wait for you. The speaker will finish with his speech and we enter together. What do you think?
Okay, perfect. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Maya. Okay. So now I think that you understand that it's prohibited to enter with your phone calling every time to eat bananas, right, and to talk while a speaker is on the stage. Okay, so my aim was to try to use this four-step construction, and I would like to repeat that we didn't repeat it with Geyer.